Hello everybody, this is Shpee Masterpiece Theatre, here to help raise awareness about a very clear and very present danger to society. It is pandemic level. It is spy derangement syndrome. You see, there is no question that a spy targets a heavy. It is a prime target for the spy. It is the butter on a spy's bread. To deny this fact would be to deny Spee's existence at all. A masterful Spee will lurk on the battlefield looking for their prime target and trying to devise a big brain method for how to destroy them. This can sometimes have the unintended consequence of confusing teammates, but it is okay. It is a part of the natural life cycle. You may have heard out there from other Spee mains is that the first stab is always free. The second stab should be watched out for. But after the third stab, a spy derangement syndrome will kick in. Observe here how the prey has checked his back, and now the spy masterfully... Wait. Oh, God. We missed a stab. Let's go back. Edit that bit out. Watch as he masterfully stabs his foe. And with this masterfully perfected stab from the Shpee, spy derangement syndrome is now implanted within this heavy. Observe. As Shpee is innocuously looking around and getting shot from a sniper who was shooting at something else, who knows? The heavy is now checking everybody who passes his way. He is checking the pyro who is flaming behind him. And yes, he even turns for the medic. And of course he gets random crits. Why doesn't he get random crits? Bloody random crits always happen. After checking his back, he thinks himself clear. But the Master Shpee is always looking for an opportunity on his prey. And why stop at one heavy? For once you get the taste of heavy flesh, every heavy becomes your bread and butter. Like a turkey at Thanksgiving or a ham at Christmas. Observe. Spy derangement syndrome setting in. The heavy checking everyone, even hitting us through the pylon. Is that man paranoid? Yes. Yes, he is. So busy are they looking for the Master Shpee that they fall to the one thing they swore to kill in the first place. The enemy team. Observe. As the Master Shpee is able to traverse the battlefield under a full cloak that never runs out, we see our heavy with spy derangement syndrome checking everybody on his team. And what happens? What happens? Without even being present in the fight, the Master Shpee has killed him. And now it sets in. He realizes he cannot even leave spawn. He must first check his back, and then sit back like a sniper heavy. And what is this? Even though he had a medic attached to him, he does not want to leave spawn, so what does that do? Spy derangement syndrome leaves spy looking for another target entirely. The medics become available, the soldiers become available, the scouts, the pyros, everybody becomes available. His tastes change. No longer does the heavy flesh sedate his thirst for blood. He even starts looking towards his foe like the pyro. Oh, what a tasty bite that would be. Ah, oh, damn it. Damn it. Alright. And behold, he hears the song of the heavy and stabs him. Damn it, I hate that we miss those shots. With only seconds remaining in the match, the spy lurks. Realization enters the mind of the heavy. I must push tiny cart. And at that point, it is all ogre for the heavy! Spy Derangement Syndrome has done its thing. It has manifested in his mind. It has gone beyond paranoia, beyond spy hunting. It has become the very thing of a heavy's undoing. There is no time left to hunt for the Master Spee. The Spee has won, and like a tick in the mind of the heavy, Spy Derangement Syndrome has set in. Behold, the heavy medic combo. Oh no, my friends. They are not free from Spy Derangement Syndrome either. For once the stab happens, the seed is planted in the mind, and it grows and it flourishes. Behold and observe. As the Master Spee exerts his dominance over the battlefield, they get to see it while they are dead. So they become aware that the Spee exists. And too afraid to attack, the heavy resorts to becoming a sniper. Not leaving a sniper deck. So the Master Spee approaches. Disguised as medic, realizes the medic can see him. But Spy Derangement Syndrome has stepped in, and the medic thinks he can take on his adversary. But no, my friends, that is not a possibility. For no one truly defeats the Master Spee. You may be thinking, why is this such a problem? A spy is easy to kill. You merely have to turn around and kill them. But a Master Spee, who is selective in his targets, can use the confusion of the battlefield to get away with anything and everything. Observe, as the Master Spee has slain a heavy, this confusion allows us to Uber, granting an opening for the spy to go after the other heavy, getting kills along the way, and yes! Oh, bloody hell, someone else killed him. Oh, for the love of Christ, can you just let me get the stab? This lust for blood from the Master Spee will not be sedated until he gets the kill upon the heavy. So observe. Under cloak, he changes to a teammate scout, so he is not observed on the spawning warhacks before looking for his prey. And there it is. What a tasty target it is. He will surely be coming up the ramp on the... Oh my god, he's sitting back. Get over here and get stabbed already. You disgust me, Batman. Once you begin to observe the big-brainedness of a Master Spee, you will realize the small things they do to help their team. Observe, as this Uber is not going to last in time for the sentry gun, so the Master Spee enacts his justice. And thus, Spy Derangement Syndrome can exceed the bounds of the heavy. It can actually be transferred into the mind of the medic through the use of the medic beam. In healing Spy Derangement Syndrome, the brain tick will actually travel down a medic beam. And thus, Spy Derangement Syndrome becomes an entire team affair. Observe. It is not derangement to be observant. No. Be observant for the spy. But do not let it manifest in your mind to the point of making very, very foolish decisions in the pursuit of your bloodlust. In underestimating a Master Spee, you can be the cause of your own demise. You may be thinking, but all you need to do is pursue the spy. All you need to do is a tiny bit of damage to him. Oh, sweet summer child. That is not the case at all. Observe. We are hunting a heavy. With the simple creation of an ice statue farm, the demo man and the soldier are on the case. He heard the decloak. He is pursuing his prey, but no! No! Oh, how did this guy not see that? What in the world? Get over here. While Spy Derangement Syndrome can exceed the mandate of the Heavy, only the Heavy has been observed in the wild with the final stage of Spy Derangement Syndrome, where they install a script in order to undo their own ill performance in the game. A script that will make it so that their back will never appear, and it becomes utterly impossible for a Shpee to backstab them. How does a Master Shpee combat this? We now know the utter cesspool depths that this case of Spy Derangement Syndrome has gone to. One where the honor of battle is no longer observed. Wait, Spy doesn't do honor. All of this backstabbing stuff and disguises is all dishonorable conduct. What it? Oh well, whatever. At least it's not, you know, using a script or cheating or downloading a bot or all this. God. I mean, it's often supposed that Spy is despicable for this gameplay, but what the heck is this? The Master Shpee overcomes, always, in all things. Once observing the case of Spy Derangement, oh god, we got auto-balanced! This is perfect! This is the way we defeat it. The Master Shpee causing an imbalance upon the teams in order to get himself switched and enact a vote kick. The Heavy realizing only too late what has happened. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Don't take Shpee Thonks series very seriously. If you like this video, please see my other Shpee Thonks videos, where I parody my own videos in a silly, silly way.